I was fortunate enough to be raised in a home where my mom played good music all the time. So Motown, Spinners, Marvin Gaye, the OJs. They're just kind of in me, you know. The Chicago sound, the musicians that I met around Chicago, and just the music that I was raised listening to. It just comes out naturally in the music because it's just embedded in me, you know.
Yeah, I can dig it. If those are your influences, I want to hear your music. You're watching Jazz Night in America. I'm Christian McBride. Marquis Hill is a rising star. This cat turned a lot of heads at last year's Thelonious Monk International Jazz Competition. It's like the Heisman of jazz, and Marquis won. That kind of talent doesn't just grow in a vacuum. So he went to his hometown of Chicago to meet some of his influences. First stop, a rehearsal in his drummer's basement. Here's Marquis warming up. Here's Justafan practically levitating. And here's Christopher working on his social media presence. But seriously, your regular band is a huge influence. This group has a velvety groove, and that's no accident. Marquis was really intentional about how he built his band, which he calls the Blacktet.
When I write music, I write for these specific musicians, and I like the music to have a groove. That's really the most important thing to me. And I also knew I wanted the music to be nice and open and free. And that's why I added Justin Thomas on the vibraphones, because the vibraphone, they really add that openness to it, you know, a drier sound, and it doesn't take up as much space. And Micaiah, he's a jazz drummer, but I also consider him like a really groovy drummer. And I knew I wanted that aspect in the music as well, so I know he was the perfect fit. And Christopher McBride, the alto saxophonist, we went to college together, and we started to realize we have a similar sound. You know, we both have darker sounds, and when I formed a band, I knew immediately I wanted him to be on the front line with me.
That makes sense? So I'll make that very clear.
And the bass is Josh Ramos. He's just kind of a brick house. He swings, he's soulful, he plays in the church, and he's got all the aspects that I like in my music and his playing. So I kind of pride myself on having this band sound and building off of this sound. And it also helps artistically because you know exactly what you're writing for. You know the strengths and the weaknesses of your members. So it's a cool thing.
But let's not get carried away. This is just their rehearsal. We recorded their real show at the Jazz Showcase in downtown Chicago. First up is a tune called White Shadows. That song grew from a less friendly sort of influence. Here's Marquis.
The story behind the tune is I was on tour and we stopped at a Cracker Barrel, and I'm walking through the store and I just noticed I was being followed throughout the store. And you know, that never rubs you the right way. So in my mind, I was like, oh, I have a white shadow behind me, you know, following me throughout the store. So I got back on the tour bus and I came up with this composition.
Thank you.
All right. This next one's entitled I Remember Summer. I Remember Summer.
What was the name of the last one?
That was White Shadow.
White Shadow. That's my favorite.
That's my elementary band ever. To give it up for Miss Ellis in the house. Yeah.
For decades, Diane Ellis has taught jazz at Dixon Elementary School on the south side of Chicago. She's exactly the kind of person you'd want teaching your kid music.
I lived, eat, sleep, talk every day, 24/7, music, preferably jazz, since high school. It's been my life and my living and my happiness.
And Ms. Ellis was more than a band director for Marquis. He considers her a mentor. Quick pause. Mentorship is a tradition in jazz. Almost all jazz greats apprenticed under older musicians, who apprenticed under older musicians, and on and on. Take Ms. Ellis, for example. Before she started teaching, she was on the road with her own mentor, saxophonist Sonny Stitt. So in a way, that makes Sonny Stitt Marquis's musical grandfather, and...
Marquis Hill is my musical son. So what Sonny Stitt gave me as a musician or a young kid coming up, that's the way I feel with all my kids. I want them to get the same thing that I had. And hopefully that, like Marquis, get out there and play for the world that he has arrived.
We also caught up with two of Marquis's other mentors, pianist Willie Pickens and guitarist Bobby Broom.
Yeah, I had a regular engagement at a club here in Evanston, and I'm remembering all of this now. They were driving in from Northern Illinois University. That's like an hour drive. Whenever he had the opportunity to be around a situation where he could learn or play, he was there.
And he would come by the house and I would tutor him and give him pointers, this and that, you know. And like I said, he was always focused. He knew that every moment that we were together, he was trying to get something out of me, you know. So to me, that's very vital if you want to be a professional.
That's right, Willie. Let's get back to the music. Thank you.
Thank you.
We've heard from Marquis's bandmates and mentors, but even as a teenager, he took his musical education into his own hands. And before the internet, that meant digging for new tunes at the local record shop.
We're driving in Hyde Park, and we're on like 55th and Woodlawn, near the high school I attended, Kennewood Academy. It's been really 4 years of my life just kind of roaming this area. Dr. Wax is really where I bought a lot of my records, but they're now closed, but we're headed to Hyde Park Records. On lunch break, you know, at Kenwell, we would get an hour lunch, and we had off-campus lunch too, so as soon as the bell rang, oh man, let's go over to Dr. Wax, let's go over to the Hyde Park Record Mart. It was either that or go to the practice room, you know. It was never eating lunch, though. We would buy records and check them out and, you know, make sure we don't scratch the disc and trade them and get some cash and buy another one and trade amongst one another. And it was really cool, man. That's how I discovered a lot of the music I know today. As a trumpet player, you know, it was Nicholas Payne and Roy Hargrove. You know, it was me and my group of trumpet player friends. We were all about those two, definitely. Let's see. Whoo! Probably my favorite. Here's another one, Fuego. Another one. Yeah, Donald Byrd is definitely, I would say, one of my biggest influences. And people never believe me when I say that. Pharoah Sanders. Man, I've got to get a record player, man. You guys just motivated me to get, to find me a damn record player. Quincy. Whoo! $5, man. You can't beat it.
Back to the show. Here's Black Harvest. Thank you.
Guys, good night.
You can hear more music from this concert on our radio show. Check your local listings or visit npr.org/jazznight. I'm Christian McBride. Thanks for watching.